more often than not, you're going to play harder, you know, because you're a little embarrassed.
First shift of the night for the Islanders. Top line, Barzal driving to the net with a shot. A save from Lindgren.
A good save. He was trying to go 5-0, and there was a bit of a hole there, but Lindgren covered it up in a hurry. His brother, Brendan, plays for the New York Rangers. They played against each other the other night, not last game. And guess who won?
That would be Ryan Lindgren.
Yeah.
5-1 win for the Rangers a couple of nights ago.
Oh, you think that he wasn't licking his chops all night on that one?
Here's a chance for Brock Nelson to shoot it. That one sticks up to the left arm of Chucky Sideburns, as they call him, Charlie Lindgren. Linesman talked to him for a while. He had three of his players around him for a while. And looks ready to go. Puck is down. And we're back underway. Right to the net it comes. And Lindgren will cover it up and we'll do it all over again. Joel Edmondson fires it off the back wall. Squeak to the front. It's still loose and grabbed there by Paul Murray. That was a simple play that got awfully complicated as Sorokin hangs on to that one. Islanders have a chance to move ahead. Passes in the skates of Barzal. Ovechkin had lined him up. The puck taken by McMichael and give it to Wilson. Tom Wilson with a shot that sticks to Ilya Sorokin. Winning some hockey games. Defense, goaltending, penalty kill. I'll tell you what, Charlie Lindgren just doesn't look right in that net. He's stretched out. He's been moving along.
Must have did something, huh? Maybe pulled a muscle or something.
Paul Murray, the drop, ankle ball to the slot, holds onto it, shoots, and it wound up deflecting wide.
Was he looking for...
He's feeling the effects of that as Paul Horvat chases down this puck. Here comes Anders Lee over the line with Barzal. Matt Barzal opens up, shoots, save made, and squeaked free. Lee to the front, and it's tapped wide.
Well, Lee didn't see Barzal. He was wide open.
Bolduca shot. That one missed the net at 94 miles an hour. Bortuzzo almost banked in by Horvat. Loose outside the crease and cleared down the ice by the Capitals. It'll be icing.
Washington had some excellent chances, but Boldu gets the puck, and Horvat tries to bounce it in off.
Turnover. Stuck in their own zone again.
Turnover by Nelson.
In front, kicked out by Sorokin. It was Mantha on the doorstep. Manov on the keep-in. Engvall try to go to the front. Nelson off the backboards. Couldn't shoot it. Centers it. Paul Murray, nice little drag around Wilson. Came to Nelson right across the crease. And then Kemper there on the try from Engvall.
Well, as he has several good opportunities for the Islanders. And that was a clear by Jensen. Hit his own man. And now the Islanders.
So he plays with that one for the moment. Sandin trying to get by him. Cut off by Gauthier. Will start ahead. Dobson alertly jumping up on the rush, giving the Islanders on man. Romanov. Pajot scores! What a shot from J.G. Pajot!
Oh, you know, he's got to be feeling pretty good about that plan. No, Gauthier does a good job of anticipating along in his own zone and starts the playoff. He jumps up on the play. Watch this. It goes all the way across to your right of your screen. There's Gauthier, intercepts the pass, and in the middle of your screen, here comes Dobson, and he pushes all the defensemen back off, and that allows Pajot to let that rocket go up in the toy department. So Dobson, he may not get a point, but the goal doesn't happen without him backing everybody off. And tremendous shot by JG. You and I talked about the balanced scoring.
Gauthier and Romanov get the assists. On the first goal of the night for the New York Islanders. Here's Barzal looking for more. Barzal drops. Dobson scores! Two quick ones for the Islanders. They have a 2-0 lead over the Capitals. First in 19 games for Noah Dobson.
Boy, that is such good hockey. Over to Brent, look at it, up the pass. And the impressive thing is that Barzal has it. Look at Dobson. That wouldn't have happened a year ago, Brendan. He wouldn't have thought about getting in the offense right away. Does Barzal see him? Yeah, he saw him a way long time ago. He knew he was getting up on a play. And that was a rolling puck, Thomas.
So the sixth of the season for Noah Dobson, who played more than 28 minutes in the 7-0 loss on Wednesday, as Bortuzzo shot save. Rebound jammed wide by Engvall.
Yes, no more focused.
Broken up by Holmstrom at the line. Here he goes with Pajot. Holmstrom off the skate of Sandin. It popped to him in front, and he couldn't get it to go. Pajot gloves it down. A penalty upcoming here as Holmstrom tries to keep it alive.
Holmstrom knocks this down. You don't see the angle. Should have moved it right away. Pajot was ahead of him. Besides that, Pajot's the setup guy, Brendan. Give him the puck early and then skate and look for a return. But they go at it. They keep working. Tremendous opportunity for those two guys. Kemper just went down right away and said, okay, I'm going to cover the bottom of the net here.
Riley keeps it alive. Riley, Horvat, quick pass for Barzal. Anders Lee jammed it on goal, kicked away by Kemper. Short pass, shot from Wilson, finds the glass, took a hop off the stanchion. Edmondson keeps it alive. LaPierre. Now for Wilson, bumps off the hit from Bortuzzo. Strong with a chance and lunging to make the stop was Sorokin.
I'm in as many games as he's come back, and what a chance from Stroman.
Halfway through the third, still a 2-0 lead for the Islanders. Horvat overskated initially. Fires that pass through, a firm one to Pajot. Rebound, score! Gauthier, 3-0. That's a big goal for the New York Islanders.
Their D-to-D passes, and Horvat's going to get this puck on the wing. He's going to show patience, waits, and sees Pajot, who came off the bench. Good middle to the inside. And Gauthier, why not come down the middle of the ice? Brendan, the puck might come to you. And you talk about taking dead aim. Look at Horvat waiting, and there's Paj coming to the middle of the ice.
And if JG doesn't go to the net...
Here's a chance for the Capitals to come right back, and it was Gauthier who helped break that one up, but a 2-on-1. Pajot and Gauthier. Pajot, Gauthier, scores! Julian Gauthier, a couple of goals in 18 seconds.
Quick up again by the Islanders. I believe that was Bolduc or Riley. But look at this pass, and what a good move. Didn't panic, didn't shoot it right away. He says, no, I'm going to my backhand. Pajot hung on to it, and then right underneath the pad. Beautiful goal by Gauthier.
If you want to stay in the lineup, you can do the little things, or you can score two goals and have an assist, a 3.9. That's going to keep you in as well.
Hands off for Wilson. Back to Strome and his skates, and Gauthier got back in a good defensive position. Here's Holmstrom. Pajot headed into the zone. The puck was supposed to be dumped in. It came to Pajot. Scores! Have yourself a night! Fourth point tonight for J.G. Pajot.
Fought the bouncing puck. You can see number 10, Holmstrom, come back in there. Hangs on, takes, waits, and look. I was going to throw it all the way in. I don't know how that ended over to Pajot, but oh man, did he ever do some dipsy doodling. And you know, I talk about guys when they're playing the game and they get close to the net and they try and score, Brendan. There's no thinking involved. It's all just reaction. It's an ability to score the goal.
Sandin will rim it around for Obe Kubel with 24. Into the Islander zone, working on more 2-0. Sorokin, it's in! Sorokin went to clear it away, and it leaked through his legs. And the Capitals break the shutout with 17.9 on the clock. He stands up to try and clear this one away, and just whipped on it.
Well, yeah, exactly right. He missed it. I don't think even Obe Kubel even touched it after it got to. That hopped on him. Oh, that, my goodness. Freeze it, right, Brendan?
Yep.
I mean, that's what his mentality is going to be. Why not just freeze it? That's really incredibly bad luck, though.
Islanders, though, a couple of nights after a 7-0 loss, a solid response and a 5-1 win over the Washington Capitals.